I'm Dr. Anne Lindboe. I'm a pediatrician and a former expert witness and forensic pathologist. And now I'm the Ombudsman for Children in Norway. I've been seeing quite a lot of these little boys as a pediatrician, and I've seen the complications and the pain they have gone through after being circumcised. And to me, it's completely unnecessary to do this surgical procedure to healthy little baby boys. It's always like that when it comes to when children's rights get in conflict with the adult rights, and the religious freedom of adults and parents. It's taken well care of in Norway as well. Yes. So we don't take enough care of the rights of the child, and that's my job to take that view. And what surprises me is that we argue like little babies can have adult diseases. We argue that circumcision can prevent spreading of HIV and sexually transmitted diseases, and that is not diseases that you see in children. So why should you circumcise children to prevent this kind of diseases? I'm also very surprised that some people still mean and say that babies don't feel pain, because obviously they do. They feel as much pain as, at least as much pain as adults. I read the statement of the American, what do you call it, Pediatric Association, and I was a bit surprised that they actually argued. They said that, well, to save money and to prevent spreading HIV and sexual transmitted diseases, it's okay to circumcise little boys. There's no problem waiting until the child can decide itself if it wants to get circumcised, because you don't normally don't get these diseases until you reach adulthood. So it's not a good argument at all. And I also think it's very wrong to argue with money when it comes to children's rights. Children's rights is important, and you shouldn't argue like saving money. That's not important in this matter. And Norwegian physicians, they have already made a statement that there are no medical benefits for children when it comes to circumcision. And but they are still debating whether it should be legal or not to do it. And I think we have to be honest about that. We have to discuss on terms of the child, what benefits the child itself, and not us. It should be adults we're talking about, because it's not. And I think the Norwegian physicians, they are quite clear when it comes to that it's no medical benefits for children when it comes to circumcision. And well, I think our colleagues in the state should learn from that. Now I think we have to be honest about that this is actually circumcising healthy babies. It is actually a form of violence against the child, and according to the Convention of the Rights of the Child, children are protected. They're against violence, should be protected, and I think we just have to start thinking about it as another form of violence, and then. Because that's what it is, and when you do that, I think it will be much more easy, because then we just can't allow it anymore.
So you're saying that the child's right effectively trumps the parent's right of religious expression?
Yes, of course. Mm.
Okay. Mm.
The child itself, the boy itself, should decide whether he wants to be circumcised or not, and then you have to wait until he's old enough to make this decision himself.
Are you comfortable with older children making that decision?
There will always be a question about pressure from parents, but in Norway we have the age limit of 15 and 16. At that point we're allowed to decide for yourself if you want to be a member of a religious community, and you have to decide. You also have the right to decide about health matters. So it's kind of difficult to give him the child those rights and still say, well, you're not allowed to go on and get circumcised. So that's why I've said that we should have a lower age limit of 15 or 16. But of course, there is also always a risk that it can still be pressure from the parents at that age.
Are you aware of any other ombudsmen or commissioners for children who either do feel the way you do about this or who might be persuaded?
I think all the Nordic countries, we are discussing this, and actually we'll do this discussion next year when we're meeting. I think we're actually meeting here in Finland next spring. We discussed it a little bit when we were on Iceland this May, and we decided that, the other ombudsmen, they said that we need time to discuss and to talk with the children and to listen to their opinion about this. But hopefully, I think that if I get my will, next year we'll make a comment together as ombudsmen from all the Nordic countries, saying that
Europe,
we...
And then the world.
Yeah. Yeah. A common statement, hopefully, from the ombudsman next year. I would like to encourage adults and males that has been exposed to circumcision and had complications and problems because of that to write letters to the Norwegian government, to the Norwegian health minister, and to tell them that, hey, I had complications. This is not a harmless procedure. You, by doing this, you harm the child and you still have to live with that as an adult. So please go on and write the letters so we can persuade them together to stop this practice. I am optimistic. I'm sure it will happen, but I don't know why. But I think just by discussing, talking about this, earlier we didn't discuss it, we didn't talk about it, we just did it without asking questions. We are not there anymore. And by doing what we're doing now, keeping the debate alive, I'm sure at some time we will understand that, well, we don't do this against girls anymore. Of course, we shouldn't do this to boys either. And it will happen. It's just a question about when.